Hey everyone, I'm Jane Reeves. It's June 2022 and I am back in Switzerland for the Basel edition of Art Basel. Over 200 leading galleries from all over the world are featured in Messeplatz, the main pavilion right behind me. It's the first, dare I say, post-pandemic show. No masks required, no COVID tests. It was very easy to check in. I'm so excited to see what they have inside.
The participation is close to pre-pandemic. 289 galleries from 40 countries, including 19 first-timers, are showcasing art from modern of the 20th century to cutting-edge contemporary. The record-breaking sale is set on the opening day of Louise Bourgeois' 11-foot spider at House & Worth, $40 million. Today I'm going to feature three galleries. Here is the first one, Galerie Lelong from Paris.
I am Patrice Cotensin, director at Galerie Lelong in Paris. The gallery was established in the early 80s in Paris, but it has a long story before, because previously in the same building with part of the same artist was the Galerie Magd, which opened in autumn 1945. So in the building where we are in Paris, there had been shows of modern and contemporary art permanently since autumn 1945.
And what do you have today?
Today we have brought to Basel, as always, what we hope to be considered as great artworks.
I agree.
We have a sculpture by Jean Dubuffet, Le Chien de Gué, that he conceived in 1969, and of which this large version has been produced recently with the agreement of the Fondation Dubuffet in Paris. And this work has been admired and has been acquired also by a private collection.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
What about that beautiful sculpture in the back?
You mean the head?
Yes,
the head with the hand.
Yes.
Yes. This is done by a living artist, Jaume Plensa, a sculptor from Barcelona with which we worked since more than 20 years now. And he receives a great applause around the world. He has sculptures, outdoor sculptures, public sculptures, from Korea to United States, from Brazil to Spain, from Scandinavia to Italy and Austria. And we have presently a very important show of his work at our gallery in Paris.
I'm happy to see again Buchmann Gallery and get a closer look at its German branch.
Berlin Gallery is in Berlin since 2005, and we have two spaces. One is a bigger gallery near Checkpoint Charlie, and the other one is a smaller space in the same street where we host the archive of the drawings of Tony Craig. So usually we have two shows at the same time, one in the big space, one in the smaller space.
I started the gallery.
During the last Art Basel, I had the pleasure of meeting Elena Buchmann, the matriarch founder of the Swiss Gallery.
40 years I'm here in Art Basel.
And a few words about today's exhibition.
We brought a selection of works by Tony Craig, Jason Martin, by Bettina Pusci and Claire Woods. So I was really interested to create a dialogue between the artists and the works we present. So actually it was kind of a teamwork almost. So we would really talk to the individual artists, also tell them what we have in mind, sometimes even show them the works by the other artists we plan to show, so that everyone could react and we could create a momentum together.
Were any of the works created specifically for Art Basel?
Yes, specifically for Art Basel was created the work behind us, the polished sculpture by Bettina Pusci, but also the big painting by Claire Woods of the chandelier. This painting by Jason Martin, it's the first time it's presented. And there was another sculpture by Tony Craig, which was done for the fair. But that's already gone, yes.
So you sold it, right?
We did sell it,
oh,
yes.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
So the show was a success, right?
It was a big success. We're really, really happy. It was wonderful. to see people come back. It's like we continue where we stopped 4 years ago in 2019.
Right.
So finally people came back.
My next guest has a well of knowledge on one of the most fascinating eras of contemporary art scene, the 60s and 70s in New York and London.
In London, yes.
And what's the primary focus of the gallery?
Well, my father was then contemporary, and then when I took over in 1970, so you know, it wasn't so contemporary by the time he died. Then I had lived in America from 68 to 72 when I came back, and so I then sort of showed a lot of artists that hadn't been shown in England, like Warhol, Lichtenstein, Rauschenberg, Twombly, Rosenquist, Oldenburg, Wesselman, so, and then Agnes Martin and Eva Hess, to name but a few. Yeah.
So you met some artists. Did you live in New York when
yes,
you?
I lived. Yeah. So I lived in New York, basically for 3.5 years. Which was a bit of 68, a bit of 69, then all 70, 71, and 72.
Probably had a lot of great time.
Yes, it was the right time to be there, absolutely.
Can you please tell me a little bit about the exhibition today?
Well, when we do an affair, we try and show the idea of what our program is and will be. Mm-hmm. So we've got a little selection of drawings. We have 9 Paul Tech drawings here. Then my father was interested in surrealism. So we'd have a sort of selection of surrealist drawings, works on paper with de Chirico, Dali, Max Ernst, Dorothea Tanning, Valentin Hugo. So they're all sort of related in one way or another. And then here we have a selection of drawings by Marlo Moss, and then very early drawing by Vera Molnar, who's nearly 100 now, and she was one of the first people to do computer. You had to realize that these were, they're on the original page, you know, because they were done on these huge computers, which are probably bigger than this stand, and they had to go to universities which had them, and they had to work at night, and it was this paper which had, you know, with the holes in it, so oink out like that. But they're quite extraordinary. And then we have this sculpture by Marlo Moss, which is extraordinary, very rare thing that we sold to the local museum. Then we have I think he's a fascinating artist called John Tweddle, and they all came from this Skull collection, and Skull was his sort of, I suppose, his mentor or his, you know, the Medici for him. Tweddle came to New York in 1968 as a young, angry young man from Kentucky. And they're quite extraordinary. And they're so modern now, you know, with art written on it and in dollar signs and all the rest. You know, it's nothing's new. And then he left in about 72 or 73, went back, still an angry young man. But in those years, when he was in New York, he was collected by Philip Johnson, Skull, the Tremaines. So it was very, you know, but he sort of disappeared. But people, I bought the collection from Skull's estate, and these are all I have left. But I think they're really fun. And then we have Billy Apple there, who was originally from New Zealand, came to England. We have a show on of neon rainbows that the legendary Robert Fraser was supposed to do in London in 64. He gave him the idea, and Robert freaked, I can't, you know, this is too much. And so Billy Apple went to New York, and then he made the pieces and had the show with Paul Bianchini, and nothing, so they went back in the crates. And so our show in London, the things haven't been out of the crate since 1966. Then we have at the moment, well, it closes today in Geneva, an extraordinary artist called Verena Losenberg, who was a part of the Zurich Concrete Group. And so we have a work by her, and we're trying to build that market up. And then we have two Morellets, and then another very interesting cook, because Raymond Gurker, and we'll be doing an exhibition of his in October in London. So that's really basically it.
And now it's the unlimited. 70 large-scale projects are presented in this sector, and here there are some highlights. Andrea Zittel, AZ Personal Uniforms. Volker de Jong, The Shooting, 1st of July 2006. Isabella Ducrot, Omaggio a Mishima. Leonardo Drew, number 341. Rachel Whiteread, Untitled, Upstairs. Stano Filko, Environment S.Filklinic.deaths.f. Nida Sinakrot, High Dive. Liu Wei, Dimension. Juan Yongping, American Kitchen and Chinese Cockroaches. Carl Andre, 25 Cedar Solid, 25 Cedar Scatter. Kennedy Yanko, The Means Other Than the Known Senses. Anita Molinero, Sans Titre. Ju Ting, Winter is Coming. Jim Shaw, Not Since Superman Died. And Luisa Gagliardi, Tête à Tête. Right outside on Messeplatz, there is a tribute to the late New York conceptual artist Lawrence Weiner.
And it's an interactive installation based on the game Hopscotch, this kids' game. And people is welcome to step on it, lay on it, jump through it. It's a lot about self-development and positive thinking. As you walk through it, you will start getting ideas about how to improve the situation you're in or how to overcome some troubles. In the end of it, there's this phrase, out of sight, which is about what is about to come and what is going to happen next in life, because there's always a next.
As Noah Castro says, there is always a next.
From Basel, I'm Jane Greaves. The next Art Basel Fair is in Paris in October. See you there.